Hello and welcome to Let's Play Mountain Blade. Now I know you guys have asked me to do more Mountain Blade, or some of you have at least. And I started the Eagle and the Wolves mod. But then I found this little gem online. I knew it existed already. It's basically an 1866 Mountain Blade Western mod. So you actually get to play in the American Southwest, the border with Mexico, in Texas actually, to be exact. And it's a lot of fun. So I'm going to show you some of that, and after that, depending on how it goes, I will see which one to continue next. Of course, I might continue the other one, the old one, at some point, but right now I prefer this one because it's so much fun. It is very well built, it has a lot of options, everything you expect from a Western is in there. So, along with a good dose of humor, not too much, but enough to keep it interesting. Alright, let's start a new game. You get some nice historical facts instead of regular hints. Ah, yes. Welcome, cowboy, to 1866. Before you can start playing the game, you must create a character, of course. To begin, select your character's nationality. Now, I've played Indian already, and I've played Mexican already. I've tried those two. I liked Mexican. Indian was pretty tough, because you don't start out with any firearms worth noting. So I think today I'm going for an American. And, well, years ago, before you were born, your family moved west seeking fortune. Your journey westward in one of a thousand wagon trains was long and strenuous. Your father was... what was my father? Let's see. Let's make him a farmer. Because, well, people do farm. That's why they went west, right? And I was raised on a farm in a rural village, or in a gold rush boom town, or far from civilization. What would I do? Oh, a gold rush boom town, why not? Okay, now we get the American Civil War. There's an American Civil War in 1861, when the South got into some trouble with the North over their rights. Particularly the rights on slavery were involved. Wasn't the main thing, but anyway, you get to pick a side here. And I think my character is not gonna pick a side. I considered making a Confederate soldier guy, but he would be cooler to profit from the conflict, or perhaps a mercenary of France. Yeah, that sounds cool. We're gonna go for mercenary of France. We fought the Franco-Mexican War, so under I think Napoleon III. I'm not sure, but anyway, that's what we're gonna do. There we go. And eventually, you have to figure out what his motivation to go pursue. Making money would be logical. Yeah, my character wants to be. He wants to be rich. Is that a good motivation? No, we'll go for that good old Western vengeance. That's better. Makes for more fun. Vengeance. With rage burning brightly in your heart, you gave up your old life and devoted yourself to vengeance. What was done to you must be paid back, and this debt must be paid in blood. Blah. And we're gonna pay it. Realistic. I like playing realistic. So that's Iron Man for you. There we go. And we'll call him... John... Doc McGraw. That would be cool if Dr. Phil was like a gunslinger. Can't imagine him like that, but well. Doc, if Dr. Phil, if you're watching, this is just, you know, fiction. This is just purely coincidental. You have a cool last name. I'm sorry. Alright. boy, this character starts out really weak. But it's okay, I can handle that. Alright, we have 6 points to distribute. And we'll go for the wound treatment, surgery, and first aid. Logical choices, I'd say. Trailblazing can go up. Training, we need training, because the firearms make the game a lot harder. And some horseback accuracy. There we are. And some melee weapon skill. We're gonna need melee weapon skill at first. Some long guns and some pistols. There we go. Yeehaw. Alright, now what are we gonna look like? I know. Are we gonna dark skin? No, not gonna dark skin. Nah. I'm gonna beard him though. Oh yeah, look at that. That's wide up right there. Need some hair to match that. Need some hair to match that. Oh come on, this can't be his only hair. It is. Oh wait. Yep, yeah, this makes sense. Alright, now for the hair color. Yeehaw. Yeah. He's an older guy. Well, slightly older. There we go. In his 30s. Okay. There we go. And we're in the training field. We've got looters, but that's a lot of looters. Let's see what we've brought. We've brought a rusty double-barreled shotgun. Awesome. A rusty axe, two-handed. And rifle ammunition. Okay, and what's this, a shovel? Mining tools. Okay, cool. Alright, y'all. What are we doing all the way in Apache territory? I don't enjoy being in Apache territory at all. Especially because the Apache's probably hit my guts. I'ma leave here. I'm getting out of here. Oh, wait. 5 looters. I can handle 5.
I tell you, live from limb.
They do have that strange accent in this part of the country. Alright, the only thing you're gonna get from me is hot lead from the barrel of my gun. My double-barreled gun. Alright, I'm taking my axe out, man. It's my axe girlfriend. Oh yeah. Where are you at, I wonder? I have a donkey? Oh my god, I have a donkey. Why do I have a donkey? I don't want a donkey. That's the worst kind of animal I can have right now. Come get me, boys. I'm ready for ya. Yeah, yeah. Ha! I think I'm gonna shoot the first one that comes near. Oh, and you're in the water. That's your fault. Sorry. Whoops. Yeah. Alright. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh my god. You hurt me. He's bleeding. Chop him down. Oh, he's out of butt buzz. Yeah, that's what you get for messing with me, boy. I like the shotgun so far. It's nice. Let's see what these guys have. Whoa, pistol ammunition. Can't use it though. And a Wells Fargo Colt. We'll bring that. And the pepper boxes. They're fairly useless. And a rusted scalp knife. That's all lovely. Let's get the heck out of here. We're on the donkey. Donkey's not good. But there's a lot of looters out here. Alright, we're almost out of... Oh. Vigilantes versus Renegade Confederates. Well, that could be interesting. And again, let's not get involved. Crooks versus Grooks. I mean, that can only mean trouble. Fort Helena, there we are. Heading up to El Paso here. Yeah, El Paso, that's right. Oh, wait.
I tell you, live from live.
What's this? A thief. Alright, thief. That's fine if you want to beat me up. It's all good for me. I'm gonna find a nice little spot here. And, hopefully, a spot that I can fail. Where are ya? You a bunch of idiots. On the other side of the river. I don't even know where you are. That could be a problem. I think I'll just dismount here. There's a lot of cover here. Trees. Oh, look at that. Oh, yeah. We gotta go out into the water, gentlemen. That could be a problem. Yeah, go ahead. Into the water now. Yeah, that's right. Oh dear. Come on. Well, this happens. Thieves. And then I got taken away by thieves. Horrible guys. Lost 14 cents. That's my 14 cents. They're not very good thieves, are they? Oh, boy. And I escaped their captivity. Oh. Okay. I'll be leaving for El Paso now. Thank you. Yeah, I think I would. Wait, what's this? Marauders? Ah, 20 marauders? Ah, surrender. Lost 20 cents. Oh, come on. You gotta be kidding me. This is a bad start, people. Bad luck is what I want to call it.